We are continuing our study of the applications of integration. Today we'll be looking at future value and present value. Our goals are to solve continuous money flow problems, find present value and future value, find the accumulated present value of an investment. Earlier in the semester and in your previous algebra class, you considered a one-time deposit into an account that paid continuous interest for a set of time. You may recall this given formula. Well, now we want to consider a situation where we have a continuous money flow rather than a one-time deposit over a period of time earning continuous interest. We will call this future value of a continuous money flow. If the yearly flow of money into an investment is given by some function r of t, then the future value of the continuous money flow at interest rate k compounded continuously over t years is given by this definite integral. Now remember, r of t is the money flow per year. Occasionally, r of t will be referred to as p sub 0 or p naught. Find the future value of a continuous money flow of $1,000 per year being invested at 6% continuous interest for 8 years. The future value will be equal to the integral from 0 to 8, because it's 8 years. R of t is the amount put into the account per year, $1,000, times e to the power of kt, 0.06 t dt. Now, in order to evaluate this integral, you may recall that you would have to do a u substitution. The value of u would be 0.06 t, so du would be equal 0.06 dt. Now, the way I like to show this is I would divide both sides of this by 0.06. Therefore, I can replace dt with du divided by 0.06. Let's go ahead and show the substitution. The next step, I would factor out the 1,000. And I can rewrite this as e to the u. Now, when I replace dt, I replace it with du divided by 0.06. So I'd put the du here, and I would factor out the 0.06 there. Now we can go ahead and integrate. Of course, the antiderivative of e to the u is e to the u, but u is technically 0.06 t, and we need to evaluate this at 8 and 0. Let's go ahead and show another step. So first we replace t with 8, then replace t with 0. Remember, e to the 0 would be 1. I've already calculated this to save some time. We will check it on the calculator in a moment. $10,267.91. Let's check it now. Remember, to evaluate a definite integral, if you hit math option 9, that brings up the function integration command, and we can type in our integrand. Now, I'm going to use x instead of t, just for convenience. And that verifies our answer is correct. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at another example. What should the continuous cash flow be per year, sometimes referred to as P sub 0 or R of t, so that the continuous money flow over 10 years at an interest rate of 8% will be $10,000? So in this problem, they're telling us we want $10,000 in the future. How much should we put into the account per year? So we're actually trying to find R of t. Okay, we need to evaluate this definite integral, which again is going to require a u substitution, very similar to the last example. So let's go ahead and show our substitution. Again, we can factor out the R of t. Now remember that when we replace d of t, we're going to get a du divided by 0.08, which I can factor out. Okay, to clean this up, what I might do now is multiply both sides by 0.08. That would give us 800 is equal to R of t times the integral of e to the u du. Now we'll integrate. 800 would equal R of t times the antiderivative of e to the u is e to the u, which is actually e to the 0.08t evaluated at 10 and 0. Okay, now I've already evaluated this to save a little bit of time again. We get 800 is equal to R of t times 1.2255. And if we divide both sides by that value, we would have our annual money flow. And R of t is equal to $652.85, which means if we deposit $652.85 into an account every year over 10 years and it earns 8% continuous interest, we will end up with $10,000.